Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved. Amen. Holy One, we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are infected by sin that divides your beloved community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you in our neighbors. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen. Beloved, we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the door to us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcome. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promises prepared for us from the foundation of the world. Amen. Beauty of the earth.
first reading is from Zephaniah 1. Be silent before the Lord God, for the day of the Lord is at hand. The Lord has prepared a sacrifice. He has confided his guests at the time I will search Jerusalem with lambs, and I will push the people who rest compassionately on their jags. Those who say in their hearts, the Lord will not do good, nor will he do harm. Their wealth shall be plundered, and their houses laid waste. Though they drink wine from them, the great day of the Lord is near, near and hastening fast. The sound of the day of the Lord is bitter. The warrior cries aloud there. That day will be a day of distress and anguish, a day of ruin and devastation, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness, a day of trumpet blast and battle cry against the fortress and cities, and against the lofty battlements. I will bring such distraught upon people that they shall walk like the blind. They have sinned against the Lord. Their blood shall be poured out like dust, and their flesh like dung. Neither their silver nor their gold will be able to save them on the day of the Lord's wrath. And the fire of his passion, the whole earth shall be consumed, for a foe, a terrible end he will make of all the inhabitants of earth. What a God, what a life.
Thank you, God. Please read softly with me, Psalm 9. Lord, you have been a refuge from one generation to another. You turned us back to the dust and said, turn back, O child of the earth. You swept them away like a dream. They faded away suddenly, like the grass. For we are consumed by your anger. We are feared because of your wrath. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Second reading is first Philippians 5, verse 1 through 11. Now, concerning the times and the sessions, brothers and sisters, you do not need to have anything written for you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night, when they say, there is peace and security, and suddenly destruction will come upon them as the labor pain comes upon a pregnant woman, and there will be no escape, but you, beloved, are not in darkness, for that day to surprise you like a thief, for you are all children of light, the children of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So then let us not fall asleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep at night, and those who are drunk get drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has sustained us not for work, but for obtaining salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, so that whether we are awake or asleep, we may live with him. Therefore, encourage one another to build up each other, as indeed you are doing. Lord God, we're light.
I invite the children to come up for the children's sermon now. Good morning. It's good to see you. What should you say when somebody gives you something or does something nice for you? What should you say? You should say thank you, right? You know, when somebody does something good for you, or gives you something, say thank you. Well, coming up this week on Thursday is a special day. You know what special day is this Thursday? Thanksgiving. And Thanksgiving is the time that we especially give thanks to God for all his blessings that he gives us. We should do that every day, but especially on Thanksgiving, we thank God for his blessings. And what are some of the things that God has given us? What are some things? What? Too many things. Yes, that's true. Let's name a few of those too many things. What has God given us? Me? Yeah, okay. What else? Our church? Yes, what else? And yourself? And food? And clothes? And a home? God's love? Family and friends, and every day, yeah, we have a lot to be thankful for, don't we? So this Thursday, but like I say, every day, remember to thank God for all that he has given us, okay? So let's fold our hands and bow our heads then. Dear Jesus, thank you for family and friends. Thank you for family and friends. Thank you for food, clothes, and home. Thank you for food, clothes, and home. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your love. Thank you for everything. Thank you for everything. In Jesus' name. Ready? Amen. Okay, thank you for coming up this morning. We'll continue now with the gospel acclamation on page 8. Please stand if you are able. Thank you. Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to the disciples, "For it is as if a man going on a journey summoned his slaves and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. The one who had received the 5 talents went off at once and traded with them and made 5 more talents. In the same way, the one who had the 2 talents made 2 more talents. But the one who had received the 1 talent went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those slaves came and settled accounts with them. Then the one who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more talents, saying, 'Master, you handed over to me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." And the one who with the 2 talents also came forward, saying, "Master, you handed over to me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more talents. His master said to him, "Well done, good and trustworthy slave. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." Then the one who had received the 1 talent also came forward, saying, "Master, I knew that you were a harsh man, reaping where you did not sow and gathering where you did not scatter seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours." But his master replied, "You wicked and lazy slave, you knew, did you, that I reap where I did not sow and gather where I did not scatter? Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one with the 10 talents. For to all those who have, more will be given, and they will have abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. As for this worthless slave, throw him into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Talent. To really understand this parable of the talents told by Jesus, it is first necessary to understand what the word talent means in this parable. Now, many words have more than one meaning, of course, don't they? And this is certainly true of the word talent. When we hear the word talent, we might think of the different abilities that people have, such as musical talent or athletic talent or social talent or organizing talent or mechanical talent. But the word talent in the parable of Jesus does not refer to our natural gifts and abilities. In this parable, the word talent means a unit of money. In fact, a talent in Bible times means a huge amount of money. A talent was what a person would earn over the course of 20 years. To put this money in terms of our money today, 1 talent would be about $1 million. So knowing that a talent is $1 million, let us consider again Jesus' parable of the talents. Before going on a journey, a master gave each of his 3 servants various amounts of money. One servant received $5 million and with them made $5 million more. One servant received $2 million and with them made $2 million more. Another servant received $1 million and buried it in the ground. When the master eventually returned, he complimented the first two servants for having put the money to good use. The master told each of these servants, "Well done, good and trustworthy servant. You have been trustworthy in a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Enter into the joy of your master." But to the servant who simply returned the money that he had buried in the ground, the master said to him, "You wicked and lazy servant, you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have received what was my own with interest." In this parable, the talents, the master represents Jesus, and the servants represent you and me. In the parable, everything belongs to the master. The servants own nothing, and so it is with us. All that we claim as our own really belongs to God. In the book of Psalms, God's word tells us the earth is the Lord's and all that is in it. Thanksgiving Day, and this time of year, we are especially counting our blessings and then offering God our thanks. When you count your blessings, how high of number do you reach? 10? Or 100? Or 1,000 even? How many ways has God blessed you? Of course, when we count our blessings, we always fall far short of counting them all. We don't even come close. According to this parable of talents, the blessings that God has given us might even number in the millions. He certainly has given us so much. In the small catechism, Martin Luther wrote about the first part of the Apostles' Creed, "I believe that God has given me my body and soul, eyes, ears, and all my members, my reason and all my senses, and still takes care of them. He also gives me clothing and shoes, food and drink, house and home, spouse and children, land, animals, and all that I have. He richly and daily provides me with all that I need to support this body and life." In the hymn, "Great is Thy Faithfulness," there are many blessings listed that we have received from God, such as these: pardon for sin and a peace that endures, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow, blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Thomas Chilcombe, the writer of this hymn, could not even begin to list all the ways that God had blessed him. So he simply concluded his last verse with the words, "with 10,000 besides." Chisholm thought that the blessings that he had received from God might number somewhere in the neighborhood of 10,000. Jesus' parable, the talents, make us realize that the blessings we have received from God might number in the millions. Our God certainly has given us so much. And for our millions of blessings, we certainly ought to give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Giving thanks to God for his many blessings is a good starting point for us, but it certainly is not the ending point. We need not only to give thanks to God for his blessings, we need to put those blessings to good use for our master. Now, in the book of Genesis, we're told about how God blessed Abraham in so many ways. He gave him many servants and livestock and the promise of having many descendants who would become a great nation and receive the promised land. Yes, God blessed Abraham in very many ways. Why? Did God have a purpose for that? Yes, a very important one. God told Abraham, I will bless you and make your name great so that you will be a blessing. In you all the families of the earth shall be blessed. In short, God blessed Abraham so that he would be a blessing for others. God blessed him not just for Abraham's sake, the blessings that Abraham had received from God, he was supposed to use to bring blessings to other people. Abraham was blessed by God so that he would be a blessing to others. And that's true for you and me as well. Is there a reason God has so richly blessed us in so many ways? Yes. Like Abraham, God has blessed us so that we can become blessings for others. When the COVID pandemic shut down most things in 2020, including churches and schools and many businesses, our two vehicles sat in our garage unused most days. Other than a weekly short trip to the grocery store, there was no place else to which we traveled. So our car and truck simply sat in the garage unused. We saved a lot of money on gas during that time, but I soon realized that it would not be good for our vehicles not to be used for extended times. So we began to drive through the countryside every Sunday afternoon. Not only good for us to get out of the house, it was good for our vehicles to get the engines fully warmed up and to get their batteries fully charged. Many things get worse if they are not used. Many things are better if they are used on a regular basis. The one servant in the parable did not use at all the money that his master gave him. He simply buried the money in the ground. And his master later reprimanded him for not putting the money to good use. The main point of this parable is that we should not neglect to use what God has given us. Rather, we need to put these blessings to good use, everything that the master has entrusted to our care. There is a reason that we are here on earth. We have a purpose to help one another, to serve God, do God's work. Mary and Joseph once took Jesus to Jerusalem when he was 12 years old on the trip back home. Mary and Joseph lost track of their son. They rushed back to Jerusalem, and after looking frantically for him for 3 days, they finally found him in the temple. When Mary and Joseph asked him for an explanation, Jesus simply replied, "Did you not know that I must be about my Father's business?" And that's exactly what is true for us as well. Like Jesus, we also need to be doing our Father's business. This is exactly the reason why our Master has entrusted so much into our hands, so that we be doing work for Him and being a blessing for others. What is the work that our Lord has given to us to be doing? Well, in the gospel reading that we'll have for next Sunday, Jesus tells us that we should be feeding the hungry and giving drink to the thirsty, welcoming the stranger, clothing the naked, caring for the sick, visiting the prisoner. Other work that Jesus gives us is working for peace, letting our light shine, loving our enemies, searching for lost people, forgiving those who hurt us, welcoming children, making disciples of all nations, and sharing the good news of Jesus. We in the ELCA often say, God's work, our hands. One day our master is going to return and he's going to check up on us to see what we have been doing with all that he has given us. In the parable of Jesus, the master commended the two of the servants for putting things, the money, to good use. And he told each of them, "Well done, good and trustworthy servant. Enter into the joy of your master." But the master reprimanded the one servant who did not use the money, but instead buried it in the ground. The master called him a wicked and lazy servant. Earlier in our worship service this morning, the prayer of the day put it this way: Righteous God, our merciful Master, you own the earth and all its people, and you give us all that we have. Inspire us to serve you with justice and wisdom, and prepare us for the joy of the day of your coming. Yes, may all of us be faithfully doing our Father's business with the very many blessings that he has given us, so that on that final judgment day, our Master will say to each one of us, "Well done, good and trustworthy servant. Enter into the joy of your Master." Well done. Amen. Our sermon hymn, God Who's Giving Knows No Ending, 678, is on page 9. Please stand if you are able, and we'll sing this hymn. God's people through our baptism into Christ, living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us turn our hearts to God, our breath and life, as we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need.
gracious God, you give us talents and gifts to all your people, and you equip the church to serve. Turn us from fear and self-serving ways, that we use our talents to glorify you and encourage our neighbors to work through the ministry of your people, especially our disciples and congregations throughout the world and the ELCA, LI Lutheran Parish, and the C5 rule. Hear us, O God.
You have been our dwelling place from one generation to another. Sustain the life of the planet, protect farmlands and harvests, direct all people in wise stewardship of all the earth's resources. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. You call us to honestly and intricately instead these values in the hearts of all nations and their leaders. Free any who are oppressed and exposed all corruption and bring redemption to victims of injustice. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
You teach us to count our days that we may gain a wise heart. Where there is sickness or sorrow, bring healing. Where there is loneliness, reveal your love in community. We remember before you, especially Jim, Steve, Peter, Shirley, Doris, Shirley, Alice, Jane, George and Dorothy, Terry, Dick, Irma, Jim, Porter, Marilyn, Libby, Samantha, Pastor Scott, Teresa, Jeff, Andy, Dana, Deb, Scott, Brady, Gary, Lisa, Loretta, Elizabeth, Rita, Beth, Tim, Harlan, Donna, Steve, Marilyn, Boris, Natalie, Brenda, Lisa, Ryan, Jade, Chris, Jerry and Linda, Mick, Lisa, Mary, and victims of disasters and violence and war. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great.
We pray for the faith ministry of the church. Give to all children, youth, and adults who study the word the breastplate of faith and love. Bless our confidence, Nally, shape us by your love and show us how to encourage one another. Bless the marriage of Adrian and Kyle. Bless all newborns, especially Charlotte. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, you are faithful in all generations. For the promise of life and rest, and for the witness of those who have died in faith, we praise your goodness. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We'll continue now with the collection of our offerings. that as we gather these gifts from your abundance and give thanks for your rich blessings, we may feast upon your very self and care for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our sovereign and servant. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Then after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people. For the forgiveness of sin, do this for the remembrance of me." Now let us pray the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Communion today will be by our usual practice of intention. You come forward to receive a wafer, and you can dip it in the cup that I have, which will have the wine, or dip it in a cup that the assistant will have that will contain grape juice. There is a place for you at the banquet. Come and feast at Jesus' table. 7, let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this simple meal you have set a banquet. Sustain us on the journey. Strengthen us to care for the least of your beloved children. And make us glad and generous hearts. And give us glad and generous hearts as we meet you on the way. Amen. Catherine, if you could please bring us the announcement.
Good morning, everyone. Please turn in your covenant commitment cards and discipleship practice form in the basket in the narthex, or you can place them in the offering plate during worship. Youth and family are hosting a kids' night out Tuesday, November 28th from 5:30 to 7:30 here at St. Matthew's. Please let me know if your children or a child you know will be attending and his or her choice of a pizza for dinner. All school age children are invited. We will be decorating the sanctuary and Christmas tree after worship, Sunday, November 26th. Volunteers are needed to help move the Christmas tree upstairs and to help decorate. We appreciate the help. The church office will be closed November 23rd and 24th for Thanksgiving. Sunday school will meet downstairs in the Sunday school room today at 10:15. We won't be meeting next Sunday, so we can help decorate the church. Did you want to share this, Jonah?
Everyone was invited to join us after worship today to talk to you, so it's just in the spare room.
Very good. Please stand now for the benediction. May the God of all creation, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved, who strengthens us for service, give you reason to rejoice and be glad. The blessing of God, sovereign, Savior, and Spirit, be with you today and always. The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest seed, bless, keep, and sustain you now and to the end of the age. Amen. Ascending hymn today is I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light, number 815. Let's sing this hymn now. Thank you. beloved of God, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.